Hey everyone, I am here tonight with the game Call to Adventure. It is a... What did I do with the box? I have no idea what I did with the box. Oh, here it is. I'll put it up behind me. It is a 1 to 4 player game where, similar to role player, you are creating a... kind of creating a character, but you... let's see. Sorry about that. So, yeah, Call to Adventure by Brotherwise Games. It is a 1 to 4 player game where you get to kind of have a role-playing adventure for your character as you go out and encounter some things and do some different things in this fantasy world, in this fantasy setting where... I don't know. I am doing a really bad job of explaining, so I'll just talk about the game here a second. But you have these sections, and I'm missing my rules. Let's throw it. I guess there's a couple things that's throwing me off. Maybe I should have had the stream start a little bit later. But okay, so there's these sections, and I did feel prepared, but now I'm forgetting what these sections of the board are called. So anyway. This section here is, so from setup, your origin, motivation, and destiny. That's what it's called. Your origin, your motivation, and your destiny. And with your origin, you get two of these cards with the bronze back on the tree, and then you pick one. And I have picked performer. I'll talk more about that in a second. For your motivation, you get two silver cards, and I... picked one of those already, and then you have your destiny, which I'm not going to show you. We'll leave it as a surprise, hopefully for the end of the game. Hopefully things go well, and I can defeat the adversary. And so in the single player game, you have an adversary that you are trying to defeat. And basically, if the adversary is able to get 5 of these experience jewels, points, whatever you want to call them here, then the adversary will win. And the adversary that I'm against in this play is the sorceress. So here, in fact, I'm going to zoom in a little bit and show a couple things in the game. So we'll zoom in so we can see some things. And yep, there we go. Okay, so here is the sorceress. The sorceress we'll talk about several things because there's several unique things in this game. But first of all, the sorceress says, while this challenge is undefeated, once per turn, any player may pay an experience to draw a... See, I'm forgetting the names of all these things, even though I know what they are. But basically one of these bad... experience things. So there's two types. There's these bad ones, there's these good ones. I'll turn these so maybe you can see them a little better as we play. But you can play one of these, but it'll give you something that you might need in the game. So there's that. The sorceress also has its own deck here that is pulled out that's separate, and you look for the little skull down here, and that goes next to the sorceress. I'm gonna zoom back out here for a second, and then I'll probably zoom back in to show you more, but sorry, hopefully this isn't loud. There we go. We got a lot going on the board tonight for a single player game. For a game that's not there's no actual board here other than the player board, there really is a good amount going on. But anyway, so the sorceress is who we're playing against. Has a difficulty rating of 8. If the sorceress gets 5, the sorceress will win. The sorceress will be playing some of those cards that I showed you a second ago. The sorceress also has things like once per turn, you can discard 2 of your good guy cards here to take in. Oh, that's different. So I haven't even read anything. I've played a few games, but I haven't read this one. So this is the card that's unique to it. Other challenges with scrolls have a +1 to them. So there's challenges that are going to come out here that we're going to have to do. Whenever you gain a bad experience card, the adversary gains experience, and once per turn, you may take two of your good experience cards to take one of those red experience tokens from the adversary, which is a way to limit it. And then you have this Rise of the Adversary card, which says when you fail a challenge, they're going to gain those red experience. And when your result includes this rune, and we haven't even talked about runes yet, but that's the unique one of the most unique things in this game is there's runes that you roll kind of instead of dice. So it has an up down symbol on it. You can either take from this one or this. If you're here starting, and I don't have my marker on my board yet, but I'm here. So at this point, I can take from either. But as you go along and you get different encounters, then you either become more good, more virtuous, or more villainous. And if you go down here, you'll lose 4 points because you are a villain. So you have to balance that out. Basically, the game wants you to go this way, but you could win two if you go down here and get 4 points taking villainous actions. So one rune has that on it and has thing that counts as a success on the other side. The other runes are just blank and successes, and you're always going to roll those. We'll just set those here in the corner. And then you have things like, I guess we'll just talk about them real quick. You have your strength, dexterity, constitution, intelligence, wisdom, and charisma. And you also have dark runes, and dark runes on one side have a success. On the other side, they have that marker that shows that you're becoming more villainous, that kind of semi-circle moon shape on them. And then these are just extras for other players to mark where they are on those scales. So that's all going on. Like I said, we have these, and I'll talk about these and zoom in a second, show those more. But yeah, all those things are going on. And with that, you have to get three of these underneath your, man, excuse me, I'm not going to be able to remember, your origin. You have to get three underneath your origin, three underneath your motivation, and three underneath your destiny in order to win. But before you can get the third one here, which in this case is the sorceress, because we're playing against the sorceress, you have to do other things. So I think I'm going to move my picture here so that you can all see what I'm doing a little better. Sorry about that. I should have done this from the beginning, but there we go. And I'll just cover up my tokens. So let's zoom in a little bit and look at these cards that I'm starting with. So this one is adventure. And with adventure, it says during a challenge, if at least one of your runes shows a strength and charisma or a charisma, gain an experience. So that's cool. That's the performer, so like a bard, I guess. And this one is once per turn, you may spend experience to gain. I think that's intelligence. Yeah, that's intelligence, which kind of looks like a wand. And until end of turn. So that's cool. And that one's called Thirst for Knowledge. And I'm going to leave this a secret. This is what I am secretly trying to do, and I'm not going to tell you what it is, but I will try to remember to do it. So we'll see if I can pull this off and get some good points and defeat the adversary of the sorcerers here. So if there are no further questions, we will get playing. And actually, I'm going to stay kind of zoomed in, I think. And we will zoom in as needed when needed. Excuse me. I just hit my foot on something. Give me a second. Okay, there we go. We're going to go ahead and get started. So the ones that are out here have different things on them, the challenges. So there's either challenges, or actually, these are all four challenges. Or there could be traits that you can get. And if you get a trait, if you meet the requirements, you just get to add the trait straight up to these. But I can't progress from the first level here from my, I'm going to forget it again, from my origin to my motivation until I've got three of those first level underneath there. And if we were playing multiplayer, I couldn't I couldn't do anything on two and flip level two stuff until I had, or somebody else had, finished three. Once somebody has finished three, if I'm able to pull off a second level thing, even if I haven't finished it, that's cool. That might be a way to kind of catch up and leap forward a little bit. But at this point, playing solo, I'm just playing against myself. The other thing you should know is these runes. So they each have their own little symbol on them. So like this one is kind of this delta symbol for the strength ones. So on one side it counts as one success, on the other side it counts as two successes, the one that has the individual. But if you get the third, and you can only get the third, and you can only get a max of three, but if you get the third one, it will also have three little pips on it, three dots on it. And that one has two different things it can do. It will either give you two successes, or on the other side, it will move you down twice on your thing here. So you have to be careful how you use strength. Other ones will give you other things in the game, and we'll talk about those as they come up. So I think we will go ahead and get started. I think that's everything. So you start, like I said, two of each of the origin, motivation, and destiny. I remembered it that time. Cards, and you pick one of each, and then this one stays face down. You also set your alignment at the one that you can either be good or bad, and you get three experience gems to start off with. One more thing that I forgot to talk about is you can also journey, and journeying means that you get rid of one of these cards in the row and get something new out because it's maybe it's not helpful to what you see there. So if I were, so at the end I'm gonna need wisdom and charisma to beat the sorceress is what I'm gonna need, and I'm gonna need eight. So I wanna start doing that. I also need to make sure that I'm fulfilling my kind of secret objective here that I'm not showing you. Okay, that works. So I want to do things that are gonna bring me things I want. So I'm gonna go and survive the flames here because it's a fairly low one. It's only three. It only has a challenge of three. But if I go up here, I can use strength. I do have one strength one. So at this point, I'm gonna get the three starting ones. Oh, and I should have one good card with me too. So I get one, and I'll show you that. So right now this is in my hand, it's inner strength. Play this before you attempt a challenge. Add an extra strength or dex. Let's see. Now I'm forgetting them all. Constitution. So you can add a strength or constitution to a rune to your attempt. So I could use that now. I'm gonna leave ones that are in my hand right here, and then we'll turn the other ones that we finish upside down there to count for scoring at the end of the game. But right now, okay, I need three successes against, and I do have my three starting, so there's a possibility. And they do show you the likelihood of beating these things in the book, especially since these are very different than your typical dice. But right now, I will get one constitution rune to add, and you know what, I'm just gonna make sure that I get this for sure. I'm gonna use another constitution, and because I'm gonna go against the one down here that makes this a four instead of a three, so I get a second constitution rune, and then I just cast this like this, kind of like letting the bones fall where they may. Oh, and I had a resounding success. So a couple things are going to happen here. First of all, you have one, two, three, four, five successes, and I spent this. So that just we're just going to flip that upside down and show that I spent that. So I had five. That's more than equal to or more than. So I exceeded or equaled or exceeded this. So I get to add this, and I was going against heal the wounded. Is the one I wanted. So I will add that down here. I don't get the constitution in the future, but I do get the wisdom, and I'm gonna get a point at the end of the game for that one. So now when I roll anything that needs a wisdom check, I can add one of those wisdom runes to my check. The second thing that's going to happen is I did get this side of the one that is either a success or a draw card. So I'm going to draw because I'm going to draw either, but I tend to go towards the light side. I'm going to draw another one of the light side ones and add that and says Dazzling Wit, play this before you attempt a challenge. Add an extra charisma or intelligence rune to your attempt. Okay, so we'll just add that down there. And we're going to put the runes back that aren't our regular ones and get a new card out. And I guess I should maybe tell you. And there is an ally underneath this one. That's why that looks different. And when you're playing solo or cooperatively, because you can play this competitively or cooperatively or solo, you have the first player or playing solo, you just decide where you put these allies with the challenge. If they're all full and there's no legal space to put an ally, then you just discard the ally. But this one is, it needs dexterity and what is that? Intelligence. And it needs four. So that'd be hard for me to do right now. But if I had something else, I could work on that one. Like this one. Well, this one gives me more. This one needs wisdom and charisma, and it would give me charisma or wisdom. This one gives me a black card, and it also gives me another rune against intelligence. So there is that as a possibility. This one also gives me a rune against intelligence, but it would be a challenge of five because the sorceress adds, because this has a scroll up here at the top. Sorceress would be adding a challenge rating to that of one. I say challenge rating like I'm playing D&D or something, but let's see. I gotta think for a second, so I'm gonna take a drink while I think. Okay. Well, I don't know. Well, this one gives me an extra rune, so I could. Of charisma or this one gives me charisma or wisdom, but this one gives me wisdom and I wouldn't be penalized, so I think I'm gonna try that one. I'm gonna go ahead and play my Dazzling Wit to add because I can add my strength. Of which now I have one. So I can add my strength here, or not my strength, sorry, my constitution. And then I can add my intelligence of one from spending this card. So I have five runes to try against a four, which on the chart for likelihood means that there is a handy dandy chart. I'll show you here. It's really helpful when you're making these decisions. But this chart, and I'll show it this way. This chart says, okay, so you have your three standard runes, which is the minimum. And then if you just roll, if you only have that and you do that, you're gonna get an average of 1.5 successes. You might get three. That's not enough for me to succeed no matter what. But we go down here to where I have two extra runes, and that would give me an average of 4.5, which is above the four I need. But you know what I'm gonna do? I'm gonna go ahead and spend one more of my experience points and add. I'm gonna go ahead and add a dark rune to this. So we have a total of six runes. That means that we have now a minimum of three that we're gonna get three successes, but our average is now up to six. So it's very likely that we're gonna be able to do this. And wow, look at that. I didn't even need the dark room. Well, no, I did. I did. Oh, no, I don't, because that was four. So, I should have said I was going for the top one here. So, I got one, two, three, four, five successes. And then I have to draw a card, and the adversary. Oh, that should have happened. So, we should do this before we resolve anything, because this should have happened last time. Adversary should have drawn a card last time when we drew this one. So, Sherry is going to draw this to resolve what should have happened before I do anything else. Play this as another hero is attempting a challenge. Choose one rune of a type you possess and okay, so that would happen now. So there's no runes that they have, either wisdom or charisma that they could have removed anyway. So that's okay. That's a good card for it to come out first. Okay, and now I draw my card, and we're gonna remember that the sorceress is drawing their card too. So my card is Divine Favor. Play this before you attempt to challenge. Okay, so I'll use that. And it gives me charisma or wisdom. And this one that they drew is play this after another hero has attempted a challenge, and they must attempt it again. So this is gonna happen. I have to attempt it again, but I get to keep my runes that I had. Hopefully I don't have to draw more cards like that, because that's frustrating. Ooh, okay, so this is a much more interesting thing to happen, because now, okay, so I have one, two, three successes, and then this counts as two, so four, five successes, and then the dark rune makes me go down here, and I'm still at a point where I can draw white or black cards, good or light cards. That's gonna go back. These are gonna go back, but it dropped me. It simulates me making a bad decision of some kind, because well, I guess that makes sense, because I'm harnessing some dark power, and as I do that, as I harness this dark power, I'm also going to be drawing one of these cards. What, I cannot remember what these are called. I remember how to play the whole game, but I can't remember what all the cards are called. Oh, Triumph and Tragedy cards. That's what they are. So the light side ones are triumph cards, the dark side are tragedy cards. So I have a tragedy card. This one says, if you choose a tragedy path this turn, gain plus one to your attempt. If you choose a light path, gain. Okay, so I can go, but that'll let, actually, that's really cool, because that will let me go back up on the light path too. So we already have two cards underneath our origin, which is good, which means I just have to get one more, and then I can go up. So still only. Okay, interesting. I was hoping for a nice trait to come out that would help me against the sorceress, but I really haven't seen that yet. So if I wanted to go against this one, I need again dexterity and intelligence, and right now I would only get, let's see. And it's a scroll thing, so it's a five. I would need five successes to go against that. Can I add? That does not help me. That does not help me. Oh goodness. Because I really wanted that ally, but I don't know that I'm going to be able to get that ally, because I would need five successes. I only have one intelligence, and I have zero dexterity right now. Oh, I forgot. Once per turn, you may spend a experience to gain another. You know what? I'm going to do that. I'm going to spend one and add a total of two. So this is going to be close, because with two, my average is 4.5. So I could get more. I could get a total of seven, but it's not as likely. But I spent one. I'm gonna stick with it. I mean, the worst that's gonna happen is I get an experience point back, and the sorceress will get their first experience point too. But let's see what happens. Well, the worst happened, because I got three. And we have to draw some cards. So, first off, this is going to go away, both of these. They just get put off to the side, and we'll see what they are in a minute. But then we experience the sorceress. We draw some cards. Yeah, none of that would have helped me. I can still draw either, so I'm going to draw from the light side. And this one is just glorious victory. If you overcame a challenge this turn without using dark runes and your results exceed the difficulty by at least two, gain three experience. That's cool. Add that to our hand, but not gonna get it right now. Right now we're in a kind of weak spot. I also get to gain experience because I failed. So it's like I'm learning, and there's like a give me thing of when you fail, what do they call it? I know that's experience, but when you fail at a, if you spin, blah, blah, blah. If you fail a challenge, discard it and get, oh, it doesn't call it anymore. I thought with everything else being called something, they would call something. Okay, so I got my two. That was my card. Let's find out what the sorceress is going to do. The sorceress is going to instill fear. Play this as another hero is attempting a challenge. They must choose another challenge or trait instead. So that would cancel the one I was doing. So this actually gets canceled and goes back. So because that would happen before I failed. So these experiences go back. And I have to choose somewhere else to go, which means I don't get my I don't get my things, even though I spent one. I did spend one, so I get to keep the one that I spent, but I don't get the only. I don't know if it'll be any good. Well, I don't get it if I go against something that doesn't require. So I guess I'll go against the arcane ability and just use the same ones. That probably makes the most sense. I still need five. Yeah. And I'm going against the top one here. 2, 4, 5. Cool. So I beat it as long as... Oh, and I have to give my card. Do I have to give my... No, because I drew that before we reset things. So I'm here. I succeeded as long as the sorceress doesn't do something with cards to mess me up. Unlikely alliance. Choose another hero again. That you add their runes to the next challenge. So I'm gonna flip that up. It's just gonna be a point at the end of the game since there aren't other heroes. Okay. Well, I think it actually even says just set aside. Set aside. So we're just gonna draw a different card and set that one aside because that's useless in this game. But Dazzling Wit again. Okay, I like that. Another Dazzling Wit and. The adversary, the sorceress, is going to have the Dark Lord's champion play this after another hero has attempted a challenge. They must attempt it again. And now has plus one. So now I have to get six. Okay. So I did not get to get this card yet. And I only got four, so I failed. Now they get that. Now I get mine. Well, you know, let's do it in the right order. I fail. But let's draw our cards. This time. I should have used Dazzling Wit to add to it. Oh. Yeah, okay. So mine is Deny the Darkness, gain two, or choose another. I'll just do that right away. Again, too. And the sorceress is going to get, if any hero failed to challenge this turn, gain one. So they're going to get another. So they're going to get two, and I'm going to get one. And that card's going to go away. So that was unfortunate because they only need five experience to win the game. And there is a trait. This trait is Foundling, and it has a light path. The triumph on top is good triumph card and 3 points. And when you gain this, gain a light path, a virtue path. So, questions. I could try this one again. Right now I have, let's see. I'd have to spend this Dazzling Wood again just to get back up to four. So I'm not gonna do that. This would lower me if I take that one I can use my fateful choice, or I can banish the ghost, which I'm gonna need. You know what? I'm gonna banish the ghost because I could use wisdom against the sorcerer. So then I'm gonna try that one. And it has a low. It's just a three, so I will try that one. And I get one wisdom rune on that one. So hopefully I can get this three and do it. Oh, that's right. I can spend another here. So I could do five and try on this one. But I need. Yeah, you know what? I'm gonna do it. I'm gonna do it. I'm gonna spend one more time. So I'm gonna spend to use this ability and I'm gonna get rid of Dazzling Wood again. And then I will get my two. All right. Trying to get that five. And there we go. We have one, two, three. I fail. Four. One, two, three, four. I fail. But I have to draw a card. Nothing. Nope. Okay. Oh, I failed. Choose another hero. That one is out. Let's draw a new card. Play this before you attempt a challenge. It's an inner strength. Hopeful, I guess, but not today. And the sorceress is going to get instill fear. Oh, so this one just gets wiped again, like it never even happened. So that's good, but it means I have to go ahead and follow through with something else. I don't even know where to go right now. I guess I will. I guess I'll try to banish the ghost and get my runes, my wisdom rune that I need. Wow. So that's two, three. That's all I needed to banish the ghost. So I have my extra, another wisdom to add to my wisdom. So we can just put away those because we're not going to use those anymore. Those are all the ones, and we will slide the twos down and do that. That was something. But before we do more, I'm going to draw a card. Surprise attack. Play this before I get strength or dexterity. Okay. And the sorceress is going to get, if any hero failed a challenge this turn, gain one. I didn't fail. You like wiped mine out. I had to start over. So oh, the other thing is I have to have 30 points at the end, 30 destiny in order to beat it, otherwise this is gonna get two. Okay, so there we go. That was that. Let's flip some of these encounters from the two deck. Watch over the city, which needs wisdom and dexterity. And the four. This one has catch a criminal. Makes it one harder, but it gives you some more symbols and a dexterity and a point. Delve into darkness. This one takes you down the tragedy side, gives you strength. This one gives you a tragedy card and dexterity. Don't want to touch that really. And you may only gain this if you have two or more moons, and it's just a trait. Vengeful. And this one is outwit a gang boss. These are all negative, negative, negative. So I don't know. I might use my last experience to wipe them. I don't know. This one is it needs intelligence and charisma. And the top gives you gives you intelligence and 2 points. The bottom gives you the mask and takes you down 1 point on the tragedy side, gives you a tragedy point, and then gives you charisma. Because there are things that give you different points based on whether you're getting the triumph or tragedy. So I am not doing a good job of fulfilling my secret objective right now. I just realized that. Okay, so I need to do some things. I mean, this would be good because it gives me more wisdom to deal with the sorceress. Is there anything that gives me dexterity? Yep, here's this card. I'm gonna add this card. And Oh, this one gives me dexterity and a point. I'm going to save this one for the end. The divine favor, because I'll need that. And I really need to pull this off so I can get three more experience points. So I'm just going to play surprise attack. And that gives me an extra dexterity rune. Yep. An extra dexterity rune. And then I get my two charisma. Oh, that would be wisdom. Is there something that gives me wisdom? That might be better. Ooh. That does. Oof. That's a choice. That is a choice. I'm gonna use. I think I'd rather. Yeah. Okay. No, because I'm gonna try to pull off glorious victory. So I'm gonna use. I'm gonna put the dexterity one back. I'm not using my dexterity card. I'm using. I'm gonna use divine favor, so that I get to pull all three of my wisdom runes and use those here. So I have three extra, and I need. I think I'm gonna go for. Yeah, I'm gonna go for the top one. I mean, if I went for the bottom one. I don't need to go. I don't need fateful choice. Okay, so yeah. Okay. So that gives me a chance to. So three extra, my average is six. I only need a four. I think I can do this. There we go. So that's one, two, three, four. And then this means that I go up on. I'll show you that. That means I go up on this. So I'm at the max there. Which is good. I can get 8 points, but also I can add a little bit to play with before the end of the game. So we have Watch Over the City. I have three, which is my max of the wisdom now permanently. Oh. I mean, I could have more, but they don't add anything. But okay, so that's two, four, and then I did. I was kind of hoping to use that so I could get Glorious Victory. I didn't. Because I didn't exceed it by two, but that's okay. And then I get to get a card and place before you attempt. This gives you strength or dexterity. Okay, another surprise attack. And another card for the sorceress. Play this after another hero has attempted a challenge. They must attempt it again. All right. So I still have to get that four. That I don't think that's gonna be a problem. Okay, so two, three, four, five, six, seven. Now I got my glorious victory, and I didn't use any dark runes. So I get that. So I immediately get three experience. One, two, and three. And that also means, let's see here, that I get to keep this. And I didn't have to draw any more cards to help the adversary out. Thanks, adversary. You actually just helped me do what I want. So that's cool. So yeah, I could have more of these wisdom runes on showing on my board. I just can't get the benefit anymore. So that's the only thing. It wouldn't be very efficient to do that. I mean, there might be other reasons to do that, but right now there's not. Okay, so the new one is lead an attack. It says you need strength or wisdom, and I have all my wisdom, and it's only a five. And then if I get that, is there anything that gives me charisma? Charisma is what I can use over here. And if I take a dark side one, if I tragedy path, if I take a tragedy path, I get plus one to my attempt. So I'm gonna play that. So I'm gonna play that. and try to get this charisma. So I get my three. I have one intelligence. I have one charisma. And all I can use it. That's five on five. I think I can only play one card. I'm gonna play it as if I can only play one card. We'll just make it more interesting. I think my average then is 4.5. Yep, average is 4. We're making it interesting. There we go. Two, three, four, five. Succeeded. But we're also going to be drawing cards. So I'm going to turn this card and see what we get to happen with cards before. Second chance, face a challenge, an opponent just failed. If you, oh, we're just going to take that one out. And let's see. Play this before you attempt a challenge. Add an extra intelligence or wisdom rune to your attempt. That would have been nice to have, but that's okay. Oh, and we had the plus one, so we definitely succeed. And the last card for the adversary, before you have to shuffle and add this, play this after another hero has attempted a challenge. They must attempt it again, and it now has plus one. So now, now we can add stuff to it, but it does. We do have a plus one, so I need. Okay. So we haven't succeeded. I need five successes because I had my plus one, but I'm going to go ahead and burn this brilliant plan and add another rune because I'm kind of getting nervous now. That was. Yeah. So these kind of bounce when you, because you don't quite roll them. Let's see, one, two, three, four, five, six, and that was a one. So six is plenty, even if I add my plus one from the other, a equal. Get that, and I was taking over the game. So there is that. I took over a game. I've watched over the city. I've taken over a game. I am developing my character. I like how it's going. And then we flip over a new card here. Ooh, inspiring. You may only gain this if you have wisdom and charisma or spend two. Do I have wisdom? Yes. If I just straight up take that, I get a white card, a triumph card, and I gain charisma. I like that. I'm just going to do that. Yeah, I have charisma and I have wisdom, so I am taking that card. I feel like I'm pretty well equipped to go against the sorceress now because I have all three charisma and I have all three wisdom, which is good. So now I just have to do two level threes and then we get to go against the sorcerers and see if we beat that. I lost earlier today. I played a couple times earlier today to make sure I remembered how to play. So and right now I'm feeling pretty good about this last bit that we have to do to defeat the sorcerers. I don't feel like the sorceress is quite as difficult as some of the adversaries. Maybe I'm wrong. I might. Yeah, I am forgetting that I could discard two cards from my hand to take an experience from the adversary. Whenever. Okay, I don't think I've failed anything else that way. Okay. Yeah, okay. It's looking good. Only thing I. Oh, if during a challenge, if at least one of your runes shows a strength or a charisma gain, I do want to do that. I want to gain one more, at least one more jewel before we end up going against some, if not two. So let's see what these are. We have destroy the assassins, which takes dexterity and is a five. It's a plus one over if you try to take over the guild. It gives you dexterity otherwise up there. Wield the Dark Blade, which would give me a tragedy card. Take strength. Or I can go down here. It becomes a six if I go down here, but it gives me 5 points. It gives me strength. Okay, so that's an option two. There we go. I like this one because this is constitution and intelligence. Rogue elemental, extinguish the flame, go up here and get more intelligence, go down here, get tragedy, and okay, and then call for mercy. Dexterity and charisma. Don't really need more. So I think I'm gonna go here because I have one. I can add four. I can add one constitution and one. Oh, I thought I had more. Actually, I will go for the call for mercy. Okay, so because I can add three charisma, I'm gonna add all three of those charisma, and then do I have any dexterity? Do I have anything that gives me dexterity? Yeah, I have two surprise attacks, so I'm going to burn a surprise attack and add a dex. So I have four, which means that my average is 7.5 and I need to beat a six. So I'm going to try to save the innocent, which makes this a seven. So if I can do this, I'll get things. So let's see what happens here. I could try to do this first, but I don't have any dexterity to make this worthwhile. So I don't think I'm gonna. I think this is a good plan. Okay. All right. That's a lot of stuff. So one, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, nine, and then I have to draw cards. So we'll turn this. And I am going for the bottom here, so that was seven, just in case the adversary adds anything that makes it harder on me. Gain two sons or choose another hero to gain. So that's just a point for me at the end of the game. And play this after another hero has attempted a challenge. They must attempt it again. That's why I waited, because that's dumb with how many successes I got. Come on. During a challenge, at least if at least one of your runes shows a result of constitution or charisma, gain an experience. So I should have been doing that all along, but now I remembered. Oh, okay. There's three, four. Why is there strength? Is there strength in this? I should not have a strength in this. Oh no, the yeah. Constitution, sorry. Take that out. There we go. Okay, so one, two, three. One, two, three, four, two, four, six, and this is. Ooh, this is. I have to go down here, I believe. That's unfortunate. Haven't rolled that much, but I think that's what that is. Let's see. Draw an anti-hero card. That's what they call them. Hero and anti-hero. Hero and anti-hero. So. I have to draw an anti-hero card. Play this during a challenge you're attempting. Choose one rune and flip. I'm going to play it right now because I'm still in the middle of attempting. So I'm going to play it right now. And I'm going to flip this one. Let's see here. One, two, three. Let's see. And then if I had five and then. Seven, that would be a success. So I have succeeded. Okay, I succeeded. I saved the innocent and put that down there. I did still get to get the experience because these are charismas. Okay, that's cool. Okay, And we get a new card. One more card defeated, and then we go against the sorcerers. So you go here. You can spin one of these, or I can go here. I do have, let's see, two. I should make sure I have the right things here. One, two. That's dexterity. One, two, three. These back. I mean, this one would have been an easy one to go against, but I don't think I want to do that one. I think I want to do something more interesting. I think I want to try to extinguish the flame, which is a six. So that'd be, let's see here, three. We could spin this. And then I have one, two. So that would give me two constitutions. And then one intelligence. That gives me three runes. And then if not, I get an experience and we get something else. So I'm going for the top one here. Extinguish the flame. I need six successes. We'll see how this goes. Two, four, six, seven, eight. Perfect. Okay, so that is done. And no cards need to be drawn. So cool. Excellent. And before we can reveal this and do some scoring, we have to go up against the... So this is all done because now the only thing that matters is defeating the sorceress. And... be doing that, and the sorceress is an eight, but we use charisma and wisdom against the sorcerer. I get all three of my charisma, one, two, three, one, two, three of my wisdom. And then all three of the original runes and see if I can defeat the sorceress without having cards mess me up. Because I have a pretty good chance on the... Oh! Okay, so I have to draw another anti-hero card. I have to draw one of these. They're going to get to draw one of these. But I have... Right now I have 2, 4, 6, 7, 8, which is enough to defeat the sorceress. But we'll see what happens with cards first. This is a play before another brilliant plan. Relentless, play this after you have attempted. You may attempt it again, adding a dark room. That's interesting, so that might help. And this one is play this after another hero has attempted to challenge. They must attempt. So either way, I okay, so I'm gonna have to redo this. But the question is, do I want to add a dark room? No, no, I don't, because I like my 8 points over here. So, there we go. Okay, 2, 4, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, and I get to draw two cards. They don't matter, except that they're going to be in my hand. And the sorceress doesn't, so I have just defeated the sorceress, and then I will... go ahead and add the sorceress and reveal my hand, which is Wise Master. At the end of the game, gain 5 triumph if you have 4 experience or more, which I do. I made sure I did. And 1 for each of my charisma. So that's 8 points there. And just make sure I score correctly because sometimes I mess up scoring on games, but... I don't think I did today. I think this has gone pretty well. I just don't feel like I'm so triumph plus tragedy plus experience equals destiny. Play with the highest. Okay, so yeah. So I definitely beat that, but the question is, what is my final score? My final score is, let's see here, there's 8, 8 is 16, and then any I had on here, 16, nothing, nothing, see, I had that there like that. So 17, 18, no, 17. Okay, and I kind of messed these up, but that was, I watched over the city. I did not get the point. I was inspiring, and I took over a gang. So I had one less point there. So, okay, so 8. 8 is 16, 17, 18 points, 20, 22, 28, and then from cards in hand, cards in hand count, I believe. Well, either way, I have 10 points. 28, 29, 30, 31, 32, 33, 34, 35, 36, 37, 38, 39, 40, 45, 48, 50. If we don't count cards in hand, because I can't remember. But if we do, 40, 50. If we don't, 45. That was a resounding success. I feel like I just really was able to beat up pretty well the sources and do really well against the sources. I enjoyed this game. It's fun. It's light. It's not too hard to understand and pick up. It's a good game to just like talk about the artwork and what's going on in the game, and I enjoy it. So that is Call to Adventure by Brotherwise Games. If you watched while I was playing, thanks for watching. If you watch later on, cool. Let me know if you have any questions or if I missed something. That's totally possible. Either way, thanks for watching. Happy gaming, and I'll catch you later. Bye.